headline to fear. And I know I, whoa, amber is the color of your energy. Whoa, chains of gold display naturally.
Palm Springs students and staff. Today is Tuesday, March 7th.
I'm Yaiwa.
And I'm Billy.
And this is Lazaro.
As we start today's newscast, a huge congratulations to Mr. Bermudez, Mr. Friedman, and our band students.
This past weekend, our concert and symphonic band students represented Palm Springs with a superior and outstanding performances at their yearly music performance assessment at Jupiter High School.
These are the highest ratings in the world of music, and all of the students should be so proud of their hard work.
This comes on the heels of an awesome show last week on Palm Beach, right outside of Saks Fifth Avenue.
Keep it up, students.
Our drama students have also been working hard, and you can see the fruits of their labor next week in a drama show.
It's called Around the World in 7 Plays.
You can see the spectacular production on Thursday, March 16th at 6 p.m.
The cost is $2 for students to enter.
Hope you have some more money in your wallet, because you'll want to see our boys and girls basketball team after school in our gym.
The teams will go up against Okeehee.
Make sure to bring your $3 boys play first.
You'll also see the new uniforms for boys and girls.
Dr. McDonough is holding them up for us to see in this picture.
The new uniforms are going to bring even more good luck to the teams.
We know it's not luck though. It's the talent that's making them win.
As for our girls soccer team, they won their game against Eagles Landing Middle School in Boca Raton yesterday, putting them on track for the division championship.
But they need your support.
Their next home game is tomorrow against LC Swain. Remember, it's $2 to get into a soccer game.
Come and cheer on your team. Eighth graders, the time has come for you to vote the best of the best in your class.
Check out your email to vote for the eighth grade superlative categories.
You'll be able to vote for things like biggest flirt, cutest couple, most likely to be a comedian, and others.
Please write in the name of the student you are nominating for each category.
Voting closes this Friday at 4:05 p.m.
Winners will be announced on Monday, March 13th, with pictures taken March 14th.
If you have any questions, please go see Ms. Sazalar in room 3112B. Good luck.
The lead in the tournament of tardies competition is getting smaller.
Only 7 tardies separate 6th and 8th grade.
6th grade, you actually had your lowest tardy day during the entire competition yesterday. You now have a grand total of 85.
8th grade, you have 92.
In 7th grade, you have 163.
7th graders, a small miracle might have to happen for you to win, but how about shooting for small goals? Can you get less than 20 tardies tomorrow? That would be a first for you, and a great step towards being tardy less.
Less than 20 tardies tomorrow? I think we can do it. Remember, at the end of the competition, not only will you get a treat at lunch, but also at least one of these wonderful faces will be covered in pie if they don't win.
Sixth graders, remember to get to class on time so we can beat the other grades in this contest.
Sixth graders, don't say that. Make sure seventh graders get to class on time.
Remember, even if your grade doesn't win our tournament of the tardies, you could win the ice cream social for having 5 or fewer absences.
You may have heard 7 or 6 absences, but it's been changed to 5.
If you have 5 or fewer, you will get ice cream the day before spring break.
Your teachers have a list of who is eligible if you want to check out your third hour teacher.
You can also check SIS.
And remember, the best way to get good grades and learn is by attending school every day.
You'll definitely want to come to school next week. We have a Spirit Week.
The March Madness Latinos in Action Spirit Week starts Monday, March 13th.
On that day, you'll be able to wear class colors.
They're asking 6th graders to wear pastel yellow, 7th graders to wear pastel blue, and 8th graders to wear pastel pink.
You could also wear a spring outfit that day.
On Tuesday, March 14th, it's Pie Day. Dress from the past or future, or dress your best pie outfit. I'm not sure what a pie outfit is.
Use your imagination.
On Wednesday, get drippy with it and wear your drippiest outfit.
And on Thursday, the last day of school before spring break, keep calm and shamrock on by wearing green. Don't get pinched.
Don't forget about Saturday school this weekend.
Anyone can attend. And if you do, you get pizza for lunch and you are eligible for gift cards from McDonald's.
Saturday school starts at 8:30 in the morning and lasts until 1 p.m.
You're allowed to wear what you want. No uniforms required.
Saturday school is different from Saturday detention, which is a consequence for tardies or not behaving in class.
Eighth graders, you're also able to get help for science on Wednesday mornings.
The next topic will be mixtures and chemical reactions.
Tutoring starts at 8:15 and lasts until 9:15.
Students should meet in the cafeteria by 8:10 a.m. But if you come late, don't worry.
Students who arrive on campus when school opens at 8:45 a.m. are welcome to join in on the session for the last 30 minutes.
The tutoring takes place in room 3207. That's Ms. Masang's classroom.
Students attending the session will receive tutoring tickets, which can be collected and turned into rewards.
Ms. Masang's students are also helping you to remember science facts with a little review right here on PSTV.
This week, we will focus on acids and bases.
And on Friday, we'll have a review where one can win prizes.
Something that acids and bases have in common is that there are types of chemicals, but what sets them apart?
For one, acids range from 1 to 6 on the pH scale, while bases range from 8 to 14.
Plus, acids turn litmus paper red and bases turn litmus paper blue.
If you don't have litmus paper, another way to tell the difference is the difference between the two is by taste.
Acids taste sour, bases taste bitter.
The bitter taste protects you from poisons.
Time is running out to complete your questionnaire for the Macho Medics fundraiser.
Just scan the QR code either on your screen or look for posters around the campus.
You have until this Friday to complete the questionnaire and pay for your results.
See Ms. Hayden in room 1210A before school or during lunch to prepay for your printed PDF results.
Remember, the questionnaire link will only be available until this Friday.
You will receive your personalized printed results at the beginning of next week. It is a blazing hot day.
Let's see how the heat will affect us today with Jasmine in the PSTV Weather Sensor.
Thanks, anchors. It's a little cooler than yesterday with it being 84 degrees. There will be a high of 87 and a low of 68. Back to our anchors.
Thanks, Jasmine.
With all that heat outside, you might want to cool off.
You can buy a snow cone after school Thursday when Kane's Cones comes to visit.
Remember, it's $3 for a small and $5 for a large.
That's this Thursday. Well, students, that's all for today.
Stay tuned for today's birthdays and a special happy birthday to PSTV Ariana S.
Bye!
The party was nice, the party was bumping. And everybody having a ball. Until the fellas started in calling. And the girls respond to the call. I heard a bullet shot.